Support the work of Strike 7 Sports by heading to fanatics.com and purchasing officially licensed gear from the NFL, the NBA, and more. Each purchase made through the text link below goes into the funding of the Strike 7 Sports brand. To proceed, go to the link strike7sports.com/fanatics. I say again, strike7sports.com/fanatics. Thank you. Yo, what's up? This is your boy, Derrick Brinch at strike7sports.com. I'm joined by my co-host, Brian Botter. This is another episode of Strike 7 Sports Podcast. We're going to jump right into it. Here we go again, man. Talking about these Los Angeles Lakers, bro. They lose once again by a score of 128 to 110. 18-point loss as they close out their road trip that started in New Orleans against the Pelicans. They lose this game without LeBron James. In this game, they just got beat down from the start to the finish. This loss now put the Lakers out of play-in game contention for the time being. They're the 11th seed in the West. For playing teams, you got to be seed 7 through 10. So they don't qualify at the moment. If the season end right now, the Lakers would be out of the playoffs. Plain and simple. Final games are against Jazz, Pelicans, Nuggets, Suns, Warriors, and the Nuggets to close out the season. And they also got Thunder as well before they play the Nuggets. I want to ask you, so Friday is the next game against the New Orleans Pelicans. And the talk is that AD is supposed to be back on the court. And it's a coincidence that it's against the Pelicans, you know, to get into the, to have a shot at the play-in tournament, you know, given the whole AD situation. But I want to ask you, do you think Friday's game against the Pelicans is the nail in the coffin on the season if they lose it?
No, I won't say that, but it's a must win. I won't say that it's the end of the world because you never know how these things can go, but they're in a lot of trouble. But and the way I look at it as a Lakers fan, at this point, the way the season's gone, I'd rather them just miss it. At this point, I'm done with them. I don't want to see them get embarrassed in the first round, save LeBron's legs, and then go make one more run and then figure out what you do after that. But that's the point I've gotten to. The Lakers should just... They should try to make it, but if they don't, it's not the end of the world.
So you think they can win these games against Jazz? Because I think Jazz, I mean, they are pretty much in the playoffs. Warriors, I mean, it's nothing really left to play for. Because I think Phoenix has locked up the number one seed. I think Memphis has locked it up as well.
Yeah, they're closing in on locking the number two. But yeah, the Lakers... Even if they make it, they're not going to win. It's one thing if I felt like if they somehow made it, I thought they had a realistic shot at winning it.
Yeah.
But I don't even think that. And so it's time to just try our best for this season. But I'm already looking forward to next season. But specifically the offseason to see what they can do to give them a better shot next season.
So my second part of this question is, do you think they should shut down LeBron?
No, I think you play him until you're eliminated, but they don't technically have to shut him down right now because he's hurt. Yeah. So, gonna miss that he's already out for Thursday. I'll be stunned if he plays the Pelicans game. I wouldn't be surprised if he's out for the next week and wouldn't maybe. I think he can maybe return when AD returns, but with these sprained ankles, you just don't know. But I'm glad they're not trying to force anything. And they want to make sure that ankle is good before he comes back. So I like what they're doing with that. But I don't know when LeBron comes back, but I don't think they should shut him down until they're eliminated and they haven't got there. But they don't technically have to worry about shutting him down because he's already hurt.
True. What about the talk this morning was that they should trade AD. It was like a cluster on the – I won't say a cluster, but – like it was just spreading. It was on this show. They brought it up. This show brought it up. Kyle Hurd brought it up. Do you think they should trade or move on from Anthony Davis?
They can trade AD if they're willing. if I feel like they should only trade AD if they get a much better player in return, or really want the same package, or they're willing to rebuild. That's the only two times I think they should trade AD. But I don't think they'll do that. It's the other pieces, and maybe Russ. But I don't think they should trade AD. But I wouldn't be surprised if they do, because nothing surprises with the Lakers these days.
Yeah, I think I got some pushback online today from that story I posted about AD being the number one and all. I mean, it's cool and all, but if not now, when? And if you move on from this dude, what you bring it in? Because I got to double check it all, but I just don't. I mean, what player that you who you bring in? What team is going to do business with you to take Anthony Davis contract? And you getting to give up in return for some players to help LeBron. I mean, none of the young guys are coming over. I mean, Memphis ain't giving them Ja Morant. That ain't happening. Pelicans, they're not moving Zion Williamson. And then if you do move Zion, it's kind of like you could have kept AD with these injury issues. But in regards to this Friday, well, to Friday's game, I think I'm gonna go and say it's the dead nail, man. I think it's the dead nail for this team if they lose, man. I really do. I can see LeBron being shut down if they lose this game, and just they just say, hey, it is what it is. Frank Vogel gets let go, and they make these moves. But Friday is the game, man. I think this is it. This is the Lakers' last stand. Is kind of turned into an interesting little rivalry with, you know, AD and the Pels, and it is all coming full circle now with that trade that went down now. But I think, man, there's a lot that's going on with the Lakers, man, and I know the race ran now is just it's a different type of organization now, man, compared to when I was growing up with Dr. Jerry Buss, the late Jerry Buss, the way he's ran, Jeannie Buss, man, it's a different vibe, man. She just let her friends get involved with it, and it's just, bro, it's just a lot going on, man, and you just got people in a position they shouldn't be in, man. And how Kurt Rambis get that much power with the Lakers is beyond me, but it is what it is, man. I think they can hold it down. I think if they get into play-in, man, and I'm a Pelicans fan, I still think the Lakers will be favorite to win it, to me. If you have AD and LeBron, I think they're the favorites to win it. That's how I feel about it. But it'll be interesting to see, man. And it's a lot going on, man, in the playoffs, bro. The Celtics were the number one seed at one point, and they lost it real fast. They're back to the third seed now. Who do you think finish the season with that number one seed, man? And I don't think, and do you think it matters? It really matters. In the East?
I don't know. Probably, I'd say maybe Miami, but it doesn't matter. It all depends on, it's all, playoffs is all about matchups.
Yeah.
Home court, maybe for young teams it can help them, but it's all about matchups. You get the right matchup, you can go on a deep run. You don't, you could lose in the first round. That's the way I look at it. So, I don't think the seeding matters. I was just giving you an answer to give you an answer, but I want to see who they play in the first round. Then I can tell you more.
Yeah, they need to be playing Chicago, man. Boston playing Chicago. Milwaukee, they might have a tough matchup with somebody. Brooklyn probably. Miami may be suspect, but we'll find out. We'll see how everything plays out. All right, that's all we have for y'all for right now, man. Give us a like, comment, subscribe to the channel. Let us know how you feel. Listen to this through Spotify, iTunes. Give us a 5-star rating. Leave your comments and concerns. Also, description box below. Check out Strike7Sports.com for his content on NFL, the NBA, and much more. Have a blessed night. Peace. We out.